Tonight, BP is denying allegations that it pulled a publicity stunt on Grand Isle while the president was in town. WDSU News reporter Travers Mackle explains what the company responsible for the leak is accused of doing. Travers?
Scott, Jefferson Parish leaders say BP bussed in extra workers to help clean the beach while President Obama was in town. They call it a sad stunt to mislead the president and the American public. But BP tells us it was all part of their cleanup strategy. Just after the sun came up, hundreds of workers hired by BP started cleaning up the beaches in Grand Isle, an unfamiliar sight to people living on the island.
When I get on the island, there's busloads of people that haven't been here. What's today, day 39? Well, it's funny how they all show up on the day the president comes.
Jefferson Parish Councilman Chris Roberts didn't buy the cleanup effort.
You must think we're fools.
Roberts says it's a stunt by BP to impress the president.
To try and make it appear as though that they've been on top of their game and mobilizing assets when that's not been the case.
Roberts says since oil started coming ashore last week, no more than a dozen workers hired by BP have been seen on the beaches in Grand Isle until today with President Obama there.
I've heard estimates of anywhere from 300 to 500 people there today. They were given t-shirts and pants to wear and handed a rake and brought out to the beach.
But BP says, despite no notice of the added forces beforehand, these workers were scheduled.
We've moved in considerably more people to fight this battle on the locations where the oil is.
And Roberts and people living on the island say when President Obama left, the work stopped.
You should also recognize that these individuals are working out in the heat of the sun. These are long days. They start early in the morning and they stop in the evening. So the fact that they were leaving the location late in the afternoon is not unusual. It's not associated with the president arriving.
BP has not been forthright with anyone so far, including the federal government, the state government, and local government. And it's shameful that they would come in and try and orchestrate this effort to show the country that they're on top of their game.
Located 50 miles off the coast of Louisiana, the Deepwater Horizon oil rig exploded right before Earth Day and has spilled millions of gallons of oil into the Gulf of Mexico. In 1989, a paper in Science detailed the ecological effects of an oil spill near Panama. The authors indicated that their data could help those dealing with future oil spills in the Gulf of Mexico.
One of the reasons that their study was so valuable is that they had baseline data. So they had data about the communities prior to the oil spill, so they could compare what animals were there, what plants were there, how things were doing before the oil spills. And they found that invertebrates that couldn't move and couldn't get out of the way were killed almost immediately when oil hit land or hit the reef where they lived.
This newsreel is from 1960, produced by the American Petroleum Institute. Here's an example of a typical news story.
The trouble started down in Louisiana on the Gulf of Mexico, where the Louisiana oyster fishermen claimed that oil production was killing off the local oyster population. The oil companies didn't agree, but they decided to look into the matter. In the research laboratory, every type of condition is created for the oyster patients. A blanket of crude oil is poured directly on the water. Water is jetted through oil for 6 months. The test oysters showed no ill effects from oil, even under conditions which far exceed those ever present during oil production. As a matter of fact, the test oysters were so happy, they brought forth new generations to share their luck. They never had it so good.
Invertebrates that couldn't move and couldn't get out of the way were killed almost immediately when oil hit land or hit the reef where they lived.
The test oysters were so happy, they brought forth new generations to share their luck. They never had it so good.
Killed almost immediately when oil hit land or hit the reef where they lived.
They never had it so good.
Killed almost immediately.
They never had it so good.
Killed almost immediately.
As we move to California now, we're environmentalists drilling into your heads how dangerous and dirty offshore drilling is. And we're actually getting evidence that drilling could help the environment.
They never had it so good.
I want to tell you, I visited an oil rig off of the Louisiana coast. It survived hurricanes. It is safe. It is sound. And to somehow, and by the way, on that oil rig, and I'm sure you've probably heard this story, you look down and there's fish everywhere. There's fish everywhere. But yeah, the fish love to be around those.
They never had it so good.
You even called drilling safe, environmentally friendly drilling offshore, as raping the outer continental shelf. There, with new technology, with tiny footprints even on land, it is safe to drill, and we need to do more of that.
They never had it so good.
There, with new technology, with tiny footprints even on land, it is safe to drill, and we need to do more of that. Look at these sources of energy here in Florida that are still sitting untapped. Along with environmentally friendly offshore production, we do need to drill here and drill now. Now you can chant the drill, baby, drill.
They never had it so good.
Killed almost immediately when oil hit land or hit the reef where they lived.
From 1963 was produced by the Richfield Oil Corporation and narrated by Ronald Reagan.
Conservation-minded oil companies use scientific spacing and advanced recovery methods in the drilling of wells, thus to ensure the wisest use of our petroleum reserves. When it comes to the conservation of most natural resources, we are a responsible people.
Yes, energy industry propaganda is as old as the energy industry itself. These days, energy companies outsource their creative work to professional think tanks. One company, ExxonMobil, has recently come under fire for donating over $2 million to the libertarian group Competitive Enterprise Institute. You might know their work.
Carbon dioxide. They call it pollution. We call it life.
Oddly, Republican Senator Olympia Snow and Democratic Senator Jay Rockefeller have written an open letter to ExxonMobil's CEO demanding that Exxon stop donating to groups like CEI. Will Exxon stop? Well, we guess you'll have to ask the oysters in Louisiana about that.
Now the question is, what is the oil cleanup doing to the workers? So far, 9 people handling the oil have gotten so sick, you see them on stretchers, they had to go to the hospital. Some are blaming the chemical dispersants used to break up the oil. But the CEO of BP seems to think the problem stems from something else.
I'm sure they were genuinely ill, but whether it was anything to do with dispersants and oil, whether it was food poisoning or some other reason for them being ill, you know, there's a food poisoning's clearly a big issue when you've got, you know, concentration of this number of people.